So I'm going to play some videos here. This is not from some right-wing group here. NBC News did a report on this hacking conference in Las Vegas. And this is a conference where companies go and they bring their different products and they see if the hackers can break into them, and then they do that so they can learn how to make their products better, right? So in Las Vegas, they had this game where they gave all these hackers voting machines, right? So they brought these voting machines in for the hackers for the very first time, right? The hackers have never seen these machines before, to see if they could hack into them, right? So here's NBC News. NBC News, the headline is, or the description is, NBC News' technology correspondent, Jacob Ward, gives an inside look into how hackers can target voting systems with ease. Here it is.
What was really alarming was when you see these hackers, and these are people who've never seen these machines before, have had no practice on them for the most part, come in and engage them, they immediately get into the guts of them. Beyond that, we were seeing Dominion's image cast system. It's a line of tabulators that paper ballots are fed into. That had its guts all over the room. It was not clear to us whether this was the most recent version of the image cast hardware, but it's important to know that Georgia just spent over $100 million on a contract with Dominion to provide image cast hardware to the state in time for the next primaries and for the 2020 election. And yet here these kids were who had opened it up. They said, look, you can pop the front off of it and here's a port you can get into right here. That's easy. You know, all kinds of stuff that you could certainly do within 6 minutes behind a curtain, much less if you had extra time because any of these were connected to the web, as we discovered a couple of days before so many of them are.
Far right conspiracy news. And NBC, August 12th, 2019. It's amazing. This is not, like, what are we doing here? This is amazing. This isn't me, right? This isn't me making this up. This isn't some right-wing stuff. These are computer scientists. These are technology people. These are the hackers themselves. These have been, for years, progressives worried about Russia hacking the election for Trump. And now it's impossible. You're just a crazy conspiracy theorist. All right, so that was NBC News. Let's go even further left. This is PBS from way back, October 26th of this year. This was, what, a week? Before the election, PBS NewsHour, 1 week before the election, they had a 7-minute segment. I got a couple clips here.
So naturally, the political world is nervously watching what voters here will do, while in the world of computer science, they are tensely tracking what the voting machines will do.
Georgia's kind of a petri dish.
Alex Halderman is a professor of computer science at the University of Michigan.
There's a lot more we have to learn about Georgia's election system, and that's going to help inform how to better secure elections, not just in Georgia in November, but across the country for years to come.
He's among a handful of independent election security experts getting unprecedented access to the inner workings of the state's $107 million voting system, rolled out earlier this year. Also taking a deep dive, election security white hat hacker, Hari Hursti.
They have set up a complicated system which is centralized and doesn't seem to have any safeguards.
That's nice. The title of this segment is, Will Georgia's New Voting Machines Solve Election Problems or Make Them Worse? PBS, 1 week before the election. That last guy at the end, they called him a white hat hacker. So that's an ethical hacker, right? So it's one, again, is one of the good guys. And he said they created a centralized system that doesn't seem to have any safeguards. Oh, Slater, you're such a conspiracy theorist. This is PBS.